Before I get going any further here, Walthers provides self-tapping machine screws. They're going to fit into these holes. I don't really like to use them. In my opinion, again, this is just my opinion, these screws are too long, and when you force them in there after you've got everything in there, they have a tendency to split the posts open, crack them. Things don't stay screwed together because they're broken. The wheels come loose, the coupler pocket screws fall out and stuff. I prefer to use a 256 machine screw. I use two different sizes. I use, I probably use more sizes than that, but my two common ones are the 256 by quarter inch round head screw or the 256 by 3/16. 3/16 is a little shorter, and I think those are the ones I'm going to use on this kit, especially on the coupler pocket, because it has a real short post on there, and the 3/16 is about the shortest one I trust. I may use the quarter inch one on the truck to assemble a truck, but what is going to have to be done regardless is those machine screws are not self-tapping. So I have a 256 tap, and what I'm going to do now is carefully tap these holes out. What you do is, it's got a little bit of a tapered end on it to help you start. I'm spinning it so you can see the machined edges of this thing. The tapered head is kind of flashing in there, a little bit shiny, flashing taper there, and again the shiny side. And it's got, I don't know if you can see the threads cut in that, maybe you can, it's got the 256 threads in there. Again, this is a tap, and what you're doing is pre-drilling the hole. Now what I'll do is I'll start it in there a couple of turns. You got to make sure you hold it square to the part this direction, as well as square this direction. So I do it by hand. I've done a lot of these. You just got to keep an eye on it. Go real slow. Again, turn in a couple of turns. Bring it back out. It gets the little pieces it's cutting on the end. Again, it's going to raise a little bump on the edge as you're tapping it out. But what you want to do, and you want to do this slowly, turn the threads in, you find them just like turning a screw in after you get started. You have to feel for the threads, and then again you'll take it in a few more turns, and then you'll want to bring it back out. And I don't know if you can see the cut pieces of plastic coming out with it. I just blow them off, clean the tip off, back in I go again, feeling for the threads. Let the thing start back in there just like you're turning a screw till you get as deep as it cut. Now the other thing you have to be careful for, see, I'm in there deep enough now, I can just hold the part. The other thing you want to be careful of is don't try and twist it through too far, because what you'll do is you'll either make a dent on this side from pushing it in too hard, or you'll just go ahead and bust right through, and next thing you know you'll have a big screw hole right through the deck of your flat car. So again, just a couple of turns at a time. You can feel it cut because it's pretty tough to turn, so you don't want to really force it too far. As soon as it feels really snug, stop, bring it out, clean the chunks off the end. See, you can see the yellow pieces of the plastic on the end. I hope you can. Blow them off there. Blow the hole out, because it's going to get stuff in there too as you're cutting. And keep twisting, keep twisting. Okay, I've found the bottom again. And then again, I want to be real careful not to drill too far. You can see where the dent is. It's concave on this side, because that's a part of the injection mold process. Sometimes these things are a little warm when they take them out, and so the plastic has a tendency to warp a little bit. It's not that big of a deal in the modeling world. We're going to have a trailer over the top of it anyway, and you won't really see it. But then again, it's starting to get snug, so I'm feeling that I'm toward the bottom of the hole. And sometimes as I'm doing this, I'll leave the yellow pieces of plastic on the tip, and I'll go ahead and I'll line it up to the post just so that I can see how deep I'm getting into that post. Again, I don't have the light in the right place for you to see what's going on here, but I'm measuring the threads that as far as the yellow is up on it, and it looks to me like I'm pretty close to the bottom of that post. I don't want to twist it in there too much farther. I'm going to keep a good eye on this side this next time I'm going in here, and again turn it in just like it's a screw. It's starting in. Now I'm at the bottom. See how I'm at the bottom of that. I as I'm turning this now, it's taking the whole car with it. I'm not touching the car. It's just hanging on there. And as I turn, I'm going to keep an eye on this side to make sure I'm not pushing the tap out the other side. And it's really snug. I think I've pretty much bottomed out. And if I try and twist it too far, I'll wind up stripping it. So then that will defeat the purpose of cutting the threads in there. Again, I'll pull the tap out, clean the particles off the end. I'll go back in and I'll clean it out again. Make sure I'm getting everything out of it. Yeah, it's pretty tight in there now. I don't want to force it any farther, because if I do, I'm going to do one of two things. I'm going to strip the hole out so the screw won't lock, or I'm going to start pushing through on this side. So I'll stop for right now. And actually, I'm going to get a screw out and I'm going to test fit that hole. So if you bear with me for a second, I'll just go ahead and I've already got a hole cut in here. I'll pick a screw out with my tweezers. I'll take that screw. I'll start it into the hole. And I'm testing to make sure I have enough thread in there. Actually, I'm going to grab a screwdriver here real quick. And then I'll twist the screw down, make sure that it actually seats down to the bottom of that. Now again, you've got quite a bit of room right there. And I think I grabbed a quarter inch. Well, actually, it looks like I grabbed a 3/16. So that's about as deep as it's going to go. When I actually screw the truck on there, it will have this piece over the top of it. So that'll give me a little bit of extra distance on the screw. I may wind up using a quarter inch on there. But for right now, I'm just testing the depth of the hole so that I make sure that I've got threads in there that are good enough to bite with. And actually, I'm at the bottom, and as I'm turning, the whole car is moving, so I know that I'm at the bottom of the hole. I don't want to force that in there and strip that hole out or start to push the other side of the model out and make a dent on this side. Now I'm going to go ahead and tap out the post for the coupler pocket. It's as you can see, it's a lot smaller and a lot more fragile than this kingpin post for the truck. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to be very, very careful that I don't try and go too fast and split this thing, because these real thin ones like this, they have a real tendency to split. So what you need to do is just go ahead and again insert the tip of that tap in there and just hold one finger on the back side and just ever so slightly add a little pressure toward the car, just barely enough so that I make sure that the threads are actually cutting into the post as it's turning. If you just sit there and spin it, it's like a drill bit and it'll just start coring it out. Next thing you know, you'll be all the way to the bottom. You won't have any threads cut. So again, just a couple of turns, maybe even just one full turn or one and a half full turn, just to get it started. Back it out of there, take the debris off the end, blow it out of the hole, again put it back in there like a screw. It'll find the thread and it'll start to get back in there. It'll stop like it did for me here when it finds the end of where you've cut it out. And again, just add just a slight bit of inward pressure as you take another little twist out of this thing. And make sure it's cutting the thread and not just reaming the hole out, because this thing will, I'm not kidding, it'll be like a ream. You'll think you got some nice threads cut in there. Next thing you know, you'll stick the screw in there and it'll just fall right to the bottom of the hole, because all you've done is ream the hole out and not cut the thread. So you want to have a little bit of inward pressure on it and not too much. Again, just turning it ever so slowly, because this is a tinier post. You don't want to split it. take maybe a whole turn. You know, if you're not brave, sometimes I'm not, just take a half a turn. Wind that thing back out of there. Check your depth with the debris on the end of the deal. I'm only about maybe halfway in there, so I'm going to go ahead and cut some more. Turn it. It reaches the bottom of where you've cut. It stops turning now. You can tell that because it's actually turning the model itself when you let go of it. Again, just a slight bit of downward pressure. Cut into there, maybe half, three quarters, full turn, depending on how brave you are. Back the thing back out. Clean the debris off. Back into the hole you go. See, the reason you want to pull that out and get that debris off is because it'll build up and it'll actually put outward pressure on that post as it builds up in there, and that also will split the post. There's too much debris built up. There's cuts. There's recessed. This thing's like a triangular shape. There's cuts. Is it triangular or, yeah. And those cuts are meant to hold the debris. As it's cutting, the debris will find that low spot on the tap, and it'll go into that low spot. But you need to be careful, because if you go too far, go too fast, try and do too much, like I said, you're going to be reaming the thing out instead of cutting a thread. You don't want that to build up on there. Oh, I may have just done what I said I didn't want to do, which is strip that thing out. May have done that. Yeah, looks like I stripped this one out. So much for the demo. Yeah, and you can see, I don't know if you can see that. Zoom in. See if you can see it. It's actually cracked it. Can you see that there? It's cracked right there. It cracked it on me. Yeah, you just got to be ever so careful with these things. I have a way to fix that, though, so it's a good little experience here, so you don't feel like you're the only one that's ruining your models when you're doing this, because I've done this to so many of them. What we'll do is we'll actually put a little bit of, I use Elmer's glue instead of super glue, because the super glue, if you use it, you'll have a tendency to glue all the parts together and you'll never be able to get them apart. So what I do is I'll put a little bit of Elmer's glue in there and let it set up, and then I'll put the screw down in there to the bottom of the hole and hold it till it sets up and I know it's snug. And then that Elmer's glue, it when it dries, it'll hold that screw in there. But if you ever have any problem, if you break the coupler, need to replace it for any reason or whatever, then you've only got the Elmer's in there, and that'll break loose and you can get the screw back out. So the other thing you could do is dip the end of the screw maybe in some paint or something and screw it down in there with the paint, because again, the paint will act like an adhesive and hold the screw in place until you're ready to take it out. And that's something I'll do on the kingpin too, because I've had trains that go around the layout, and when you're done playing for the night and you lift the car up and the wheel set stays on the track because the screw has worked itself loose as it's rumbled around and put 50 or 100 miles down on your layout that night. And next thing you know, you don't have the screw holding the truck on there. So that's what I do on those also. A little bit of paint on the tip of the screw, or a little bit of Elmer's down in there. And that'll help keep the screw from twisting out.